area, the whole city, and they run away from the city. Everybody was saved and their house completely demolished, destroyed, but they were saved by the will of Allah, by Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Subhanallah, my dear brothers and sisters. And this cup of water, this cup of water comes from where? From the salt ocean. With the salt ocean, that ocean evaporate and small particles be connected to each other and traveling, and that evaporated water from the ocean that give me sweet, a fresh water for me and for you to drink. I should say Bismillah when I drink, thankful and grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one He made this fresh water comes from the salt water for me to live a normal life. My dear brothers and sisters, when you eat apple, banana, orange, any kind of different fruits, different flavors, subhanAllah, different flavors, different fruits, different taste. Who made this taste? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why I should say Bismillah when I eat this fruit, the orange, and the apple, or the banana, all from one land. It's one land. But they have different taste, and different fruits, different, something I like, something I dislike. But when I eat it, I have to be thankful and grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I should say Bismillah. Fruits, vegetable. Cooking this vegetable by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, have to be grateful and thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bismillah, it is a lot of things, a lot of meaning of Bismillah. We should be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Say Bismillah and even subhanallah. Subhanallah for everything. Ameen. So that, in summary, what is the importance of Bismillah? Of course, it's not details, of course. But let's come, my dear brothers and sisters, to our surah. Surah At-Tawbah. Surah At-Tawbah. The surah number 9 in the Quran. The surah is number 9 and 129 ayah also. 129 ayah. Okay, and Surah Bara'ah, the people they call it Surah At-Tawbah, repentance. And some people they call it Surah Bara'ah. Bara'ah, because it starts with the word Bara'atun min Allahi wa Rasulihi illa ladhina ahadtum min al-mushrikeen. Start with the word Bara'ah. The word Bari in Arabic language, please give me your attention, because I really cannot find a strong word in Arabic language, in English, to translate the word Bara'ah or Bara'atun min Allah wa Rasulihi. Declaration of association. Declaration of association, one of the meaning. Or also in the Quran says a freedom, or the translation of the Quran, of freedom from all obligations. But still, to me, it's weak translation, with all my respect, is a weak translation. Let me explain what bara'ah, the word. Bari, that means innocent person. Bari is innocent person. This person never commit any kind of crime, and some people accusing him did this crime, that he is an innocent. He never did it. That's called bari' in Arabic language. Bara'ah here, the word bara'ah, that means some people, for example, another thing, a person in a family is a family, and the person, it is an evil person. And the family, they don't want this person to be part of the family. They don't want this person to be part of the family. So we are bara'a from this person. Denounce this person out of the family. Ibrahim alayhi salam, when his father and grandfather, idol worshippers. They worship fire, some of them worship idols, some of them, and he broke the idols. So Ibrahim alayhi salam, innocent from all what they worship, that means Ibrahim alayhi salam, bari from what they say, from what they perceive. Inna bura'a minkum wa mimma ta'budun min dunihi. We are innocent of all this. We are free. We have a freedom from all this obligation. What they are doing, we have completely innocent. We're not going to be part of this. That is a close meaning for the word bara'a or bari'a. Bara'a or bari'a. I wish, I really wish if that is a clear explanation for the meaning, because I really cannot find one single word in English to translate the word bari or bura'a or bara'atun min Allah wa rasulih. All right, inshallah. In fact, Surah Bara'a or Surah Tawbah revealed in the last time, in the last days or years of the Islam. Of the Islam, it's not from the beginning of the Dawah, it's in the end almost of the Dawah. From the end of the Dawah. In fact, when it's revealed, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq was in line of the Hajj, first Hajj Abu Bakr as-Siddiq did, and then the Prophet ﷺ after him, that Hajj Abu Bakr as-Siddiq was revealed. Alright, so let's go to the first ayah, inshallah, to live with the first ayah. I don't want to explain the first ayah, live with the first ayah, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. Of course, there is no Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Bara'atun min Allah wa Rasulihi ila alladhina ahadtum min al-mushrikeen. Fasihu fil ardi. أربعة أشهر واعلموا أنكم غير معجز الله وأن الله مخزي الكافرين. Two آيات. Come to the آية number one. براءة من الله ورسوله. The translation here. The close translation, inshallah. Freedom from all obligations is declared from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم to those of the pagans, people of Quraysh, of course, the all disbelievers as in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with whom you made a treaty, with whom you made a treaty. Then the ayah number two, فَسِيحُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ أَرْبَعَةَ الشُّهُورِ وَعَلَمُوا أَنَّكُمْ غَيْرُ مُعِزِّ اللَّهِ وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ مُخْزِي الْكَافِرِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, so travel or go away freely, that means talking about the mushrikeen, the pagans, for 4 months. 4 months is a chance for them after they break the treaty, as you will throw out of the land. But know that you cannot escape or run away from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will disgrace the disbeliever. Subhanallah. Remember, the Prophet ﷺ spoke about this in Surah Al-Anfal also. The Prophet ﷺ, he make a treaty when he came to Medina. When he came to Medina, the Prophet ﷺ, he make a treaty or a covenant, a promise with the Jews over there. And then also, in the time, the Prophet ﷺ, he make a treaty with the people of Quraysh. With the people of Quraysh, not to fight for a certain years. And they call it treaty, sulh, or a treaty. So, in that case, there is no fight, there is no war for 13 years, and that's it. So the Prophet ﷺ take a chance, opportunity, to send his companion, the Sahaba, different places in the world, different kings, different leaders, different emirs, different tribes, to give da'wah. And the Sahaba become very active to give da'wah in that time, and explain what is Islam to the others. So, but anyway, those people, they break the treaty with the Prophet ﷺ. They killed some Muslims. The people of Quraysh, the pagans, they killed some of the Muslims. They killed some of the Muslims. Then the Prophet, they break the treaty. They break the promise with the Prophet ﷺ. Then the Prophet ﷺ, he broke the promise or the treaty with them by the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But not to fight immediately. Look at the Islam, how so sweet the Islam is. Not to fight immediately, no, you have 4 months. Do whatever you want, and after 4 months, I will attack or I do whatever I want. Ya Allah, Ya Allah. But Allah Azza wa Jal give those people a chance to to give make tawbah. Remember the surah is what? Surah at-tawbah. Surah at-tawbah. Then say, you break the treaty? Fine. I will break it too. But after 4 months, I will have an action. After 4 months, I will have my action. Then decide what you will do. You have 4 months. You want to come back? You want to become Muslim? Okay, I'm not going to fight you then. Subhanallah Rabbil Alameen. My dear brothers and sisters, there is two types of ibadah. Two types of ibadah. What is ibadah is? Ibadah is worship. Worship. And different types, we have two types of ibadah. The ibadah number one is ibadah sha'airiyah. What is sha'ira? Sha'ira, the word sha'ira, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala order you on, to do something. Like Allah azza wa jalla order us with salah, with siyam, with hajj, with zakah. So Allah, that called sha'air, ibadah sha'airiyah. Please give me your attention to this, is important. So two types of ibadah. Ibadah number one, sha'airiyah, that means Allah ordered you to do this kind of ibadah. Amana, trustworthy, to fulfill your covenant with the others, wafa, you know, to wafa, that means to be honest and sincere and all this. Call it transaction, to fulfill what is in the contract, a transaction. That means ibadah, call it ta'amuliyah, the ibadah or the worship of transactions. So this is two. So two types of ibadah, sha'airiyah and ta'amuliyah. The sha'airiyah from sha'ira, sha'ira that means is the obligations, what Allah order you, salah, siyam, hajj and zakah. And then ta'amuliyah, like sidq, truthful, amana, fulfilling and all this, you know, ta'amuliyah, transactions. Like take an example, Al-Najashi, you remember Al-Najashi, the king of Abyssinia, Al-Habasha, and Ja'far ibn Abi Talib, the cousin of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then Al-Najashi, he asked Ja'far radiallahu ta'ala anhu about Islam. What is Islam? From where is Islam? Ja'far radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he told him the truth. He was not afraid to tell the Najashi the truth. And by the way, the truth make the Muslims saved in Abyssinia, in Al-Habasha. The Muslims make the truthful make the Muslims saved in Al-Habasha. This is what he said, أيها الملك, O king, كنا قوما أهل جاهلية. أهل جاهلية, we were before the people of ignorance, جاهلية, ignorance. نعبد الأصنام, worship idols. And we eat the dead animals. And the strong person will eat or take over, overcome the weak people. That means the weak have no place in this kind of society. And we are like this, taking the rights of each other until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent us a man from us, messenger, from us, a messenger. We know him. We know his truthfulness, he's a truthful person. And we know his nasab, his kinship, his family. And we know that he is trustworthy. And that man, he were invited us to worship only Allah, the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one else, no idols. And we take all what we worship before, those idols and rocks. And he ordered us by the word of Allah to be truthful, to fulfill the covenant and the promises, to take care of our relatives, and to take care of the neighbors, and to stop speaking bad about the others, backbiting and slandering, and not to kill each other also. And so on and so on. He told him about what is that. All this ta'amul, transaction, how we should be as the Muslims, how we should be as the Muslims. That's why in Najashi, rahimahullah ta'ala, he made a line, and he said, your deen, my religion, and your religion comes from one resource, the resource of the Creator, the resource of the Creator. So my dear brothers and sisters, ad-deen Islami, the Islamic deen, the Islamic religion, it is the whole, the society, the deen of morality, principles, good behaviors, أن الله عز وجل told the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in سورة القلم وإنك لعلى خلق عظيم. O Muhammad, you have the highest morality among the others. Order him to have this morality, my dear brother.